My name's Sandy Norrie. I'm Arable Manager for Duncan Farms, based in Turriff, Aberdeenshire. We have 26 farms within a 15-mile radius of Turriff. Overall, cereals acreage is 7,000 acres, primarily producing grain to feed the 1 million laying hens. We also produce oilseed rape, spring barley for whiskey, and oats for milling. This season, up in this neck of the woods, we've been pretty lucky, but still very challenging with wet conditions, late drilling. We got our winter crops in just in time before the weather broke. At the moment, we're experiencing very hot, humid, sticky conditions, which is ideal for disease. And the pressures of disease at the moment in the spring crops are quite high. This season, mildew hasn't been an issue. Ramularia and rhynchosporium have been, but this is ideal conditions for that. Aphids, I think we're past the aphid stage now, so if I see an aphid, I'm not too concerned, but it is ideal aphid weather at the moment. This season has been quite good for us, really, compared to the rest of Scotland and to the rest of the UK, to be fair. I would like to see it a little bit drier, but well, well. Can't have everything. When Miravis was launched, I was quite excited to use it. So this year in Duncan Farms, we've used it in all our wheat and I've trialled it on about 20% of our winter barley and 50% of our spring barley. So I used it on all the wheat, and normally at this time of year, septoria is obviously the biggest pressure on all our wheat. Normally we've probably only got two green leaves, and in some varieties, first four leaves are still brilliantly green, and it's leaf five and six before the septoria comes in, so it's retaining its greenness. I'm just really excited about my wheat harvest this year because of Miravis. In the spring barley, I trialled 50% of my spring barley acreage with Miravis. And because of the pressures at the moment, because of the season, the Miravis treated spring barley is cleaner and greener, which is what we're looking for. The longer it's green, the more chance it has to photosynthesize and fill the grain. And that's evident in the fields I've treated with Miravis. The two main diseases for us are rhynchosporium and ramularia, and they're negligible. There's no sign of them. And the conditions we're standing in today is ideal for those diseases. So if the yield in the combine runs true to what it appears, I'll be using more Miravis in my spring barley. So I did 20% of my winter barley hectareage with Miravis, and like the spring barley, it retained its green leaf a lot longer. It's sprayed off ready for harvest now, but it was significantly later than the winter barley that wasn't treated. So I do anticipate that the yield will be better this year. I'm quite excited about my winter barley yield, to be quite honest. Summing up, I would say Miravis will be a mainstay in our farm in the future. In comparison to the farm standard in the barleys, the difference is almost chalk and cheese. The Miravis treated barleys are so much more cleaner and greener than the farm standard treated barleys, and I expect them to be significantly higher yielding when the combine's through them, which will probably confirm my decision to use Miravis on them all next year. The wheat is a no-brainer just because the lack of septoria, the yield potential in the wheat is tremendous, so I will definitely 100% be using Miravis on all my wheat. That would be my advice to anyone wanting to improve their yields and keep disease out, because disease-free crops are high-yielding crops, and especially green leaf retention, because they have the ability to capture that late sun and fill out the grains. So Miravis will be a mainstay for the next few years at Duncan Farms, that is for sure.